All right, got another dime. So I don't expect to find as much stuff here because I've gridded this out a bunch of times, but this is kind of a tourist swim area, so I'm just kind of here to see if there's any fresh drops from last year. So you probably saw in a different episode I got that really sweet silver ring. It was my first day hunting back in Montana. That was here, but the water wasn't quite this low. So anyways, we're just gonna keep plugging along, and you know, I've got almost all the junk dug out of here, so it'll go quick. I might end up having to bounce somewhere else. Another quarter. All right, I got me a nickel. All right, so I skipped showing you a bunch of clad, but I'm hoping to show you guys a nice ring. But anyways, here we go, another quarter. Okay, well, I think I've shown you guys enough clad, so I'm just trying to get whatever's interesting. So here's an old metal button. It's pretty cool. It's weird, I got a lead ball. Might be a musket ball, but it doesn't really strike me as one. Seems too smooth. Well, if you know what it is, let me know. So I could get another junk earring. Well, we just got us a little key. Got a bottle cap here too, but also got me a little crawdad. See him? Earring. I don't know what that is. Looks like part of an address. I got the zero. Alright, well, you have to dig this one. I did hear it with the metal detector first, but it's like an ear gauge. Those are always trash, I think. Okay, so I just busted through the snow for a high tone, and it came up a little, I can get in the sun, a little religious pendant. But it's pretty damaged. Looks like something went through the middle of it there. It's definitely not precious. It's very light. So anyways, we'll keep going. Okay, got a 910. Sock on the camera. Try to keep this noise down. So 910. So this is quite possibly a ring. Oh, it is a ring. Look at that. What the heck is that? Oh. I think it's gonna be junk. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, it spins. So if it spins, it's probably for sure junk. I mean, the only hope for it would be that it's white gold. I don't see any markings in there, but either way, man, that's pretty cool. It's always exciting to pull a ring out. But yeah, these swimming areas, like, you're so much more likely to find a ring than other places. And then this place kind of acts a little bit like the ocean. The you can see the incline's so steep that a lot of the time the aluminum kind of washes up there, and the heavy stuff still sits down in here. So you don't have to dig that much junk here either. But anyways, cool. Let's keep going. You see, we're getting pretty consistent high tone here. So this might be. This is right next to where we dug the other ring, see? Just a few feet over. mean, this might just be a herring and quarter, but there's a pretty good chance of those numbers. This is a real chunky silver ring. Nope. Just a quarter. Alright, let's keep going. Okay, so I had high hopes for this one. You can see it's kind of deep, and it was a 12. Ended up being a nickel, though. Look at that, I found a ring. And I proved giants exist. Look at that, I think I found Gandalf's staff. How cool is that sunset? Well, hopefully I can find a little gold or silver before that sucker goes down. All right, so I'm at a new place. I have been here once before, but I just dug a pull tab, now a nickel. Look at that crazy shrimp growing underneath the dock here. It's pretty cool. Well, I found a big old chunk of keys or whatever. Yep. All right, I'm working the muck under this place. But as you can see, I got my muck boots on, so. Anyways, just got me a ring. It was ringing up in the silver range, although don't know if it's silver yet. Geez, that's interesting. Let's see if I can wash it off. So it's got a stone on top. I don't know. It's not really striking me as silver. Alright, well, I'll check it out. Probably see a thing that says 925 below if it ends up being that, but hey though, on the jewelry. Alright, look at that big old fishing lure. It's a nice one. So anyways, I've been just digging like crazy under here. See how muddy it is. Can't even really fill in your hole because your footprint just makes one. And you know, there's glasses there. I've already dug seen two pair. But I feel like it's been dug a little bit. You know, like I'm having no problem getting nickels and pull tabs and stuff. But I'm not getting a ton of high tones. I have got a few quarters and things, but I mean, that's fine. I'm here looking for gold anyways, but let's see what happens. I'm gonna keep digging. Got me some really gross sunglasses. Yeah, this is a Boomin 28 right here. Probably a lid or something, but let's live dig it and see. Yep, lid. Okay, just dug a really loud 17. I'm gonna glove off here. And I think I see jewelry. Yep. That is no doubt bling. But second ring of the day. Okay, got me a cell phone. I'm not sure what kind it is. That was all kind of right together. Got myself an earring. I really thought this was going to be silver. It just kind of has that patina to it, and then it was, you know, wiping off and stuff, but yeah, I haven't found a mark, and it kind of seems light, so at least for now, I'm going to call that bling. Okay, I don't know if you guys can see this, but I'm pretty sure I got gold here. The thing of it is I dug a nickel, and then there was still a quarter, and when I was going for the quarter, this just flipped out of there. And then I, you know, put my machine on it. You see, it's kind of a weird shape. And it doesn't sound very good. In fact, it's hard to hear it, and it comes up a 3 or a 4. It'd be hard to say if I would have ever dug that, but hey, sometimes it pays just to be lucky, right? So, I don't know. Don't know where it would say it. Oh, I think I see it. I think right on that edge right there. I think it says 14K. Look at that. Gold. That is so cool. Man, I gotta admit, I've been on kind of a dry spell for precious metals lately, so I'm pretty stoked about that. But you just gotta keep digging. Dig the crap signals, dig them all, because see, look, this was totally masked by the quarter and the nickel. In fact, I haven't even got the quarter out yet, so. Anyways, that is an awesome pendant. Can't wait to get home and weigh it. It's not real heavy, but it's a cool piece for the collection. Okay, so this is the hole that I got that gold out of. And there's the quarter I hadn't recovered yet. Boom. Okay, well, I thought I was done. Got a penny out of there, so. That's a pretty important example of why you just gotta dig it all. I mean, maybe I would have dug that, but it was masked by 3 other coins, so it was lucky I got it, but I did get it because I dug it all. So, okay, this isn't a wrap up, so don't leave. This is just me going to have lunch. And I thought, man, my bag's heavy, I should get rid of this stuff. So, this is what I dug this morning. There's the good stuff. There's the trash. So you can see, I'm barely showing you guys what I'm digging, but I'm trying to make it entertaining for you and at least, you know, kind of show you the good stuff. So anyways, that's what it takes right there to get gold. That and all them nickels. Oh, look at that sucker. All right, well, I'm gonna go eat and then I'm gonna throw this trash away. And I'm gonna hit it again. All right, I just wanted to talk about this one just a little bit more. So I didn't end up finding really anything else. I did a detector for about another hour and then I realized I was just super tired. So I'll leave some for another day. There's more work to be done there, but anyways, I want to talk about kind of how I accidentally found this, because, you know, once I got it out of the hole and I started scanning over it with my machine, it's so choppy that I don't know if I would have dug it had I just heard this sound alone. And it kind of reminds me of something that another metal detectorist told me, is that you probably will find more diamond rings if you start digging those choppier sounds, because, you know, the diamond rings, they have so many little points and stuff holding in the diamond that it'll give kind of a choppy sound. And so, you know, maybe that's a good pro tip for everybody, is that we're all missing a little bit of gold
because we're all looking for that nice, clear, you know, kind of banging sound, when maybe we should be digging the choppy sounds. You know, a choppy sound in the gold range may just be something like this. So, I mean, I say I dug it accidentally. I mean, I was out there digging for gold. I mean, I was digging every sound really that came at me, especially if it was a gold sound, you know, anything from 1 to 21, I was digging it on the Equinox. So I can't say I wasn't like trying for this, but I certainly wasn't digging this sound when it, you know, I was actually digging a quarter sound. I guess originally a nickel sound. So anyways, it's just kind of a good little lesson, not only for me, but for you guys. So, you know, I think there's the chains and, you know, weird shaped gold like this, and maybe even diamond rings. Maybe we're all missing them because we're just trying to dig too clear of sounds. So, all right. Well, if you like this video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'd sure appreciate it.